we ask people, what do you hear? What are you looking for? And people say, on many occasions, I want to be a part of something that's bigger than myself. To know that I matter and that what I'm doing matters. Well, MCCDC is a part of that, and it matters. We are part of a denomination, Metropolitan Community Churches, which is a global denomination that is fighting, yes, I said fighting, for freedom and justice and equality. And we have the honor today to host a presentation by our very own Reverend Elder Darlene Garner, who is the Director of the Office of Emerging Ministries. So I'd like to invite Reverend Elder Darlene to come forward for our presentation with one of our partner organizations for MCC.
yet again, MCCDC, you and your people have allowed those of us who are both related to you and sometimes outside of you to be here to have that moment that Rabbi Heschel told us was praying with our feet. Every bit as much a part of our worship that works for Jesus, that is a daily slog. The Religious Coalition for Reproductive Choice works for to be the religious voice for reproductive justice in the United States. I wanted to just very quickly on the meeting tell you about how the leadership of Reverend Elder Moderator Dr. Nancy made such a difference with your help. When MCC joined RCRC as a denomination 3 years ago, it was like 11 in our 42-year-old alone. A bunch of folks who got tired and, you know, just sort of, yeah, we do this every year. And, you know, the fight goes on, and why are we still talking about road versus way and all that? MCC people got in and were excited about it, and all of a sudden there were new names on the rolls, and there were letters going to people in Congress from parts of the country that they hadn't heard from before, and they were MCC folks. And so, yet again, MCC showed up at those marginal places, not the usual suspect places. And you know that our moderator served on the White House Council on Faith-Based and Neighborhood Partnerships, President Weinberg, and served us so well as that group dealt with the issue of human trafficking around the world, but also right here in Washington, right here in this state. And out of that, we asked her to be part of what we were doing to try to move the administration to fund abortion care that is compassionate care for women who have been raped in conflict. We know from the Sodom and Gomorrah story, remember our Bible study about our homosexuality, that rape is a tool of war, is as old as the scriptures, and it goes on and on today. And so many people find themselves in horrible situations with great choices and resources. And out of her experience of dealing with trafficking, out of all of that rich experience she has had throughout the years interpreting sexuality and sexuality full of pride and happiness and joy and not always sadness and grief, she was a powerful voice at the White House. So I've met and made my lovely little presentation, because that's my job. I'm the president and the CEO, and I made my point. And the president's people sort of said, yes, brother, well, it's not the right time for me. And then Nancy leaned in. And you can imagine what happened for her. The whole conversation changed. The conversation became pastoral. It became about people she had known, people that she had studied about with one of the staff members there in the room. Experiences they've had. And you all helped make that happen. So I wish I could turn right around and give a great partnership award to MCC, because you all have been that for RCRC, and we are really truly most grateful. I want to say just one other quick word. I am now the retired president and CEO of RCRC. Mike and I have had a perfect storm of health issues in the last couple of years, and we are being called to sit down and to rest for a while, for a season. And we have moved home to South Georgia, where we are surrounded by our families, everybody we love by blood lives within about 90 miles of us in rural South Georgia. So we live on a lake, on a fish, and we're front and garden in the back. It's a pretty good thing. So pray for us, please, as my sisters and brothers in Christ. As we find our new normal, it's hard for us. We grieve the loss of who we've been in the world. But we, as the Bible teaches us, don't grieve as people without hope. And Reverend Dwayne, thank you so much.